Imagine someone has given you a file which consists of unknown numbers, a bunch of zeros, ones, twos, and A, F, E, C, D, and etc. And you have no idea what these numbers are. But that person tells you that if you load this file on your microcontroller, it would do a specific function for you. For example, it sets up GPIO pins for this microcontroller to control three LEDs with one push button. What software are you going to use to load it on your microcontroller? This is what we're going to cover in this video. What these numbers are? What do they tell us? What do they want to show us? We have no idea what are they. But microcontroller can understand them. And if we upload these codes on our microcontroller, we will see the output because it understands the numbers. So, as a review, you remember when we went to these options for target and on output, we checked this create hex file. So the hex file is created for us. So let's go and find it. We go to the location where our project is built. For me, it is in keil projects, YouTube, GPIO, again GPIO, in the MDK ARM folder, GPIO. We have to find the hex file. Yeah, here is the hex file. This is what I showed you at the first of the video. And these numbers are hexadecimal numbers. They range from 0 to 9 and then A, B, C, D, E, and F because this number are the representation of numbers in hexadecimal form. That is why they are shown in this manner. We have to upload this file to our microcontroller. For this specific function, we're going to use ST-Link Utiltiy. You could see the icon. I click on it. And the window is open for me. Let me connect my ST-Link to my laptop first. So, I want to connect the microcontroller via this ST-Link to my laptop. I would do it right now. In this manner, yeah. And as you can see, the code is running on our microcontroller. When I press the push button, three LEDs start to blink respectively. We've already discussed how to write the code and how to upload the code to our microcontroller via keil IDE software. We just have the hex file and we're going to upload that hex file to our microcontroller. Keil creates that hex file and uploads it itself. But we've imagined that right now we've just have the hex file and we want to upload it on our microcontroller. So let's get down to business. Let's go back to ST-Link Utiltiy. In order to make sure that the ST-Link is connected properly to our laptop, I hover the mouse on this option. Connect to the target. It checks whether the ST-Link is connected to laptop or not. When you see these strange numbers here, it means, yeah. The ST-Link is connected successfully to your laptop. And connection mode, connect under reset, debugging low power mode enabled. So everything is just fine. And you don't see any errors here. So you could go ahead. We want to upload that hex file, those bunch of strange numbers to our microcontroller. So we have to load it somehow to this software, which is called ST-Link Utiltiy. Here, as you hover your mouse on this icon, it says open file. So let's open the file. And I've already uploaded it here, but you have to go to the specific location that you have created your project. In my case, it is in keil projects, YouTube, GPIO, GPIO, MDK ARM, GPIO, and here it just shows the hex file, which is because the supported files are just shown here. So I click on it. Yeah, the file is loaded successfully. And before uploading this code on the microcontroller, I want to full chip arrays. So you could see that it arrays the program from the microcontroller. Let's click on it, full chip arrays. A full chip arrays will be performed. Do you want to continue? Of course. So let's see whether the microcontroller runs the code or not. As you can see, when I press the push button, the previous code doesn't run on our microcontroller. So the ST-Link utility has successfully erased the code from our microcontroller and it's just fine. Let's continue.
By this software, you could also update the firmware of your ST-Link. By clicking on this ST-Link tab, firmware update, device connect, ST-Link is not in the human, please restart it, okay. I need to reconnect the ST-Link. Device connect, it is detected successfully. And upgrade to firmware, this version, yes. Brilliant, upgrade is successful, okay. Close the tab. And as you hover your mouse on this icon, it says program verify. It both programs your code on your microcontroller and verify whether your code is right or not. Here shows the path of your hex file. We already declared it and clarified it. And click start to program target, verify while programming. It's just fine, you don't need to change anything here. Reset after running, of course. So as soon as I click start, the program gets uploaded to my microcontroller.
As soon as I click to start, the program is uploaded on our microcontroller. Well, it is done. So let's click the press button. Wow, it works as expected. Everything is fine. And it is some wiring problems. Yeah, brilliant. Bouncing problems. It works just as expected, and you've successfully uploaded the hex file on your microcontroller. So the next time if a person gives you a hex file, you know how to upload it on your microcontroller. And you don't need to know what those numbers mean at all, and nothing. Just need to upload the program with your ST-Link utility software on your microcontroller. Nice job. Have fun.